Hello and welcome to Nikolai's Genetics Lessons, and today is going to be the third lesson in which I explain how to memorize one and three letter abbreviation of amino acids. So far we have learned these 10 amino acids, and today we are going to learn these 6 amino acids. One more lesson and you will know all abbreviations. Let me remove now those parts which we are not going to use today, and we are going to concentrate only on these 6 amino acids. First two amino acids are going to be isoleucine and leucine. How we are going to memorize them? And take a look first at this picture. So what do we see here? Here is a leucine and here is a isoleucine. What's the difference? Take a look. Chemical formula is going to be the same. Isoleucine, the name itself means isomer of the leucine. So here is a leucine and this is just going to be isomer. Take a look. This methyl group in the leucine would be attached to, here is a carbon alpha, carbon beta, carbon gamma. So would be attached to carbon gamma. And in the isoleucine, it would be attached to alpha beta. So it's going to be gamma 2. This is gamma 1 and this is going to be gamma 2. And here it's going to be attached to the carbon gamma, but it's going to be carbon delta. So this is going to be delta 1 and this is going to be delta 2. So now you understand that leucine has a priority over the isoleucine because this is isomer of the leucine. Hence, three-letter abbreviation in the leucine is going to be L-E-U, first three letters, and one-letter abbreviation is going to be L. And in the isoleucine, now you see that it consists basically of two words, isomer and leucine. So first letter comes from the first part of the word, so I here, and this L-E stands for the two letters of the leucine. So I-L-E and not I-S-O, as you may probably think. So first letter of the first word and two letters of the second. And one letter abbreviation, it is I. It is easy to memorize because only one amino acid start with I. And the only difficult part would be to memorize that three letter abbreviation is not going to be either, but instead I-L-E. Next, lysine, how to memorize this amino acid. First three letters come from first three letters of the name of this amino acid because there is no conflict about this, but one letter abbreviation as you see is K because L is already taken for leucine. And you probably also would experience difficulty here how to memorize which of these two has one letter abbreviation. L. You may ask yourself whether it's going to be leucine or lysine. And now just memorize, because leucine has isomer, which is isoleucine, so it's more important. Of course, this is a mnemonic technique, so it's more important than lysine. So it takes one letter abbreviation, which is L. And lysine, because letter L is already taken, would take letter K. Why K? Because K, L, M. M is already taken for methionine, so we just take K, which is a letter that goes before L. K, L, M. So lysine, one letter abbreviation, is going to be K. Methionine is very easy to memorize. Only one amino acid starts with M. So first three letters come from the name of the amino acid, and one letter abbreviation is just going to be M. Phenylalanine, first three letters come from the name of the amino acid, and instead of P here, so this amino acid starts with P, we have F here. P and H is read as F. It is very easy to memorize, but how to memorize it? Proline would be P and not phenylalanine. Proline, again, take a look at this picture. Here's a proline, and proline would be the most rigid amino acid because it has a side chain which is cyclic and ends on the amino group. So it doesn't bend or rotate and would be the most rigid of all amino acid. And rigid we also think as strong. So proline would be stronger than phenylalanine. So proline would take one letter abbreviation, which is P, and phenylalanine would take one letter abbreviation, which is F. And three letter abbreviation is just going to be first three letters of the name of this amino acid, because there is no any conflict about these first three letters, only about one letter abbreviation. Again, memorize that proline is stronger than phenylalanine. Now it's time to check if you have been able to memorize all these abbreviations. And here goes first amino acid, second, third, fourth, fifth, and sixth. Now let's recall three letter and one letter abbreviation. Proline, it's going to be P, R, O. No any conflict with first three letters. And proline is stronger than phenylalanine. It's more rigid. So it takes one letter abbreviation, which is going to be P. As for the phenylalanine, three letter abbreviation is going to be P, H, E. And one letter abbreviation is going to be F. Lysine. And now probably you still can be confused which would have one letter abbreviation, which is L. And do you remember that leucine has isomer, so it's more important than lysine. Leucine would have three letter abbreviation L, E, U, and one letter abbreviation L. And lysine would have three letter abbreviation L, Y, and S. One letter abbreviation, I hope you remember that this is going to be a letter that goes before L, which is going to be K, K-L-M. Isoleucine consists of two words, isomer of leucine. So first letter in three letter abbreviation comes from the first word, and this is I, and second two letters comes from the second word, which is L, E. And do you remember what is going to be one letter abbreviation? It is very easy. This is the only one amino acid that starts with I. So no any conflict. So one letter abbreviation is going to be I. And methionine, also the only one amino acid that starts with M. So three letter abbreviation is going to be first three letters of the name of this amino acid. And one letter abbreviation also is going to be just M. Now we can check if we completed this table correctly. And as you see, everything is correct. And you also see how easy it was to memorize this 6 amino acids. So now you know 16 amino acids out of 20 amino acids. Under this video in the comment area, I'm going to provide links to my other videos on this topic, so you can also watch those videos and learn names and abbreviations of other amino acids as well. Just remember, don't try to learn everything in one day. The best thing would be to learn in 4 days, spending 5-10 minutes a day and 5-10 minutes to review what you already learned in previous lesson. And this is all for today. Subscribe and see you in the next video. Goodbye.